Greetings, everybody. It's Leviathan here, and the PTR for patch 2.4.1 is live. We're going to go ahead and do a quick review of the patch notes that they sent out today, Tuesday, March 8th, and then we're going to figure out what's going to be good coming up for the season, hopefully, season 6. So starting out here, just general server performance improvements. They're saying that they're hoping a lot of the stuff that results in massive calculations, so like really high GRs, we're stacking up lots of mobs, you have lots of dots, area damage, all that good stuff. They're hoping that they've actually addressed those issues so you don't get that like slideshow lag frame rate drop issue that we currently have. So that should be cool. They're doing a server slam this coming weekend. I believe it's March 11th to March 13th. So if you are one of those players that benefits from playing in a group, going up to those high GRs, I highly recommend hopping into the PTR that weekend and testing things out, because they're going to be taking our feedback and hopefully improving it as the PTR goes on. They fixed another issue. Massacre bonus experience apparently wasn't being calculated correctly previously, so that's fixed up. A couple of class changes. So we knew about this one for Hammer of the Ancients Birthright. They made that change so they can't spawn all crazy health globes. It now heals for 3% of your max life on critical hits. And then we knew about this one as well, the Ignore Pain for the party sharing part of it, the mob rule. It's reduced from 50% to 25%. So your allies only get half the benefit. And then the passive skill, Tough as Nails, I guess they're trying to push a little Thorns thing ahead for the barbs. They went up to 100% instead of 50% for Thorns damage bonus increase. Demon Hunter, Companion. The Boar Companion, this looks like it's going to help parties out a little bit. Life per second and resistance bonus are also granted to your allies, which is nice. And then for the Wolf Companion, the damage that it grants is now multiplicative, so that's really huge. And then for Steady Aim, this one's also multiplicative now too. So this kind of the theme, I guess if we had to say like a general overarching theme of this PTR so far, all the major damage changes are just making things that weren't multiplicative before now multiplicative. So it should result in quite some heavy damage output across pretty much every class. Witch Doctors, they got a Grasp of the Dead change to combat that health globe issue again. So instead, it now has a chance to summon a zombie dog, increase to 70% for the Death is Life rune before you used to drop some health globes or had a chance to. Wizard, Firebird's Finery, 2-set bonus, now activates before Unstable Anomaly, so that's nice that your shorter Cheat Death passive goes off. Although I think they might both be 60 seconds. Wizard things, I don't know. And then Archon just got crazy buffs across the board. Like, I think Archon might be one of the strongest wizard specs. We'll have to see what players find from that, but there's just all this right here. Bonus became multiplicative on improved Archon. Damage bonus just generally increased. Armor and resistance went way up. Like, that's almost 8 times as much. It's just crazy. And then a teleport cooldown got reduced, so Archon is just absolutely insane now. A couple of item changes. This one is amazing, right? Legendary potions can now be salvaged and will yield a Forgotten Soul, so now you actually have a reason to pick them up and not just make them litter town. And then a lot of legendary gem changes. We knew that some of these were coming because they told us that Taeguk was going to be changed. So now we know what the results of these changes are so far. Remember that PTR, of course, is subject to change as time goes on and as they do different updates to the PTR. So we don't know for sure if all this will stick, but here's some of the general idea. Bane of the Powerful now has an extra part to it, so that rank 25 also reduces damage taken from elites by 15%, and the damage bonus granted here is multiplicative, so more multiplying. Enforcer, pet damage went way up. Oh, pet damage reduction, sorry, went way up to 90%. Before, the damage reduction was just 25, so that'll make your pets way hardier. And then the damage bonus granted to the pets, multiplicative, who would have guessed? Gem of Efficacious Toxin, poison enemies deal 10% reduced damage, so that's kind of nice. Little damage debuff that you can get on your enemies. Golgotha Swiftness, it's completely redesigned, and it now applies swiftness with every attack. It also grants a 0.50% chance to dodge per stack, and then the dodge chance is increased by 0.01% per rank. So this is pretty cool. You can get, I think someone was saying at 50, rank 50, you're getting 15% attack speed, 15% cooldown reduction, 15% dodge. So it's pretty nice. The old favorite of Condemned Crusaders back in the day, Mirai Teardrop of the Starweaver, increased the smite damage up to 3,000. Additional damage per rank is increased from 40% to 60%, so every time you level it up, you get 60% more. Duration between smites that you get from the rank 25 is down from 5 to 3, so that's good. Smite more often. And now it also heals you for 3% of your max life each time it hits an enemy. So that's pretty interesting too. It seems like they added a lot of like healing and defensive components to gems. This one could be interesting for builds that maybe lack single target, but it seems hard to compete with this, or to compete with Bane of the Stricken, because that is like the Greater Rift Guardian killer, but maybe this could help throughout the Rift a little bit better. We'll see. Moratorium got a little update. Chance to clear staggered damage is increased from 10% to 20% per kill. So that's now one in every five kills, potentially clearing all that staggered damage, which is nice. Pain Enhancer, the bleed was increased, the damage, from 1,200 to 2,500, so that's pretty huge. And then additional damage per rank is increased from 30 to 50%. Simplicity Strength, damage bonus granted is now multiplicative. It's pretty interesting. So some generator builds definitely getting buffed up. And then the heal amount also increased from 2% to 4% of max life. Crazy. Taeguk, this one we knew about, completely redesigned. So now only gain stacks when you spend resource on a channeled skill. Stacks up to 10 times. The stacks expire after 1.5 seconds. Grants 2% damage per stack. Damage increased by 0.04% per rank. And grants 2% armor per stack at rank 25. And so there's currently an issue with the PTR though, where it's only granting 1% armor per stack. Okay, so that one's kind of interesting. A lot of people are saying it's kind of a nerf to take it because you're losing defense. Before, I think the armor used to just scale up because you could get tons of stacks. And so that armor was just always getting better and better. But now here it's going to have a limited amount that you'll get. So just 20% looks like. So I don't know. That's one we'll definitely have to keep an eye on and see. Wreath of Lightning. Lightning damage increase from 600 to 1,250% weapon damage. That's a nice big boost there. And then additional damage per rank is from 10 to 25%. So that went up. Zai Stone of Vengeance. Damage bonus per rank is increased from 0.05% to 0.08% for every 10 yards between you and the enemy. That's pretty good. Depth Diggers. It's now multiplicative. So again, generators, man. I don't know. Generators getting a lot of damage sources multiplying. Could be interesting. Oculus Ring. This is really awesome. This makes Oculus Ring pretty much the best ring for your follower now. So this will also be activated by your kills if it's equipped on your follower. So there's like no reason to not have an Oculus Ring on your follower now. Sanguinary Van Braces. I'm curious about this one. It's now benefiting from all sources of bonus damage, which makes it sound like it wasn't before. So maybe this will actually be a little bit better with the Thorns of the Invoker setup. Or this could even be... chance on being hit. So yeah, maybe Invoker. I was going to say maybe in the Lawn Bombardment, but you're not really trying to get hit in that build, so... we'll see. Solanium, we knew about this change. So now it only drops a health globe once every 8 seconds, and that's an internal cooldown that was added to that weapon. Existing legendary items have been updated to include a unique legendary power. You have to find new versions of them, of course. So Frostburns has cold skills, deal plus 15 to 20% increased damage, and a 50% chance to freeze enemies as a legendary power. Mage Fist, fire skills, deal plus 15 to 20% increased damage as the legendary power. Interesting. So you'll just be able to cube that and use it as a fire bonus on your armor slot. Barb specific stuff. A lot of the sets got buffs, pretty much just huge damage buffs across the board. So IK set went up from 250 to 400%, creeping back up to that 500% that we saw in the PTR that one time. Legacy of Rakor, 300% to 750% on the 6 set bonus in there. So trying to get people to wear the whole 6 piece set instead of the 4 Rakor, 6 IK. Might of the Earth, damage increased 800 to 1200. Skull Grasp, everyone's really curious about this one. Completely redesigned, your Whirlwind deals 250 to 300% additional damage, and this is now multiplicative with the other sources of Whirlwind damage. This was the biggest issue with this ring in the past, was that it was additive, so it really didn't do anything for you. But now it's multiplicative, could be useful, could be worth using. And then here, they're really pushing Rend forward, Wrath of the Waste 4-piece set bonus. damage reduction is increased from 40 to 50%, and your applied Rens deal triple damage. So the double Ren build that was really popular, I think Alkaiser, whatever his name is, made this really popular 2 seasons ago, or last season maybe, and that was kind of the best barb spec, so this could do some crazy Ren damage going forward. Crusaders, here we go with the good stuff. Got a new flail, Flail of the Ascended, new legendary two-handed flail. Your shield glare deals damage equal to up to your last 5 shield bash casts. So basically you do shield bash, shield glare, and now you have whatever that 5 times those damages were out in your shield glare. It should be insane, especially when you pair it up with that shield that gives you the full surround shield glare. I'm really excited to try that out. Roland set looks like it's going to be crazy. I'll actually skip ahead to Roland's 2 down here, because the 4 set bonus damage went up a little bit, 600 to 750, and then the bonus duration on the 6-piece set went up from 5 to 8 seconds, so some really good stuff going on there. Johanna's Argument, keeping Seeker of the Light up to date as well. The Blessed Hammer damage is increased by 100%, so you're getting that increased attack speed and now increased damage to your Blessed Hammer. Thorns of the Invoker is getting a little bit of a love tap too. 25% to 35% on the 2-set bonus, and then 6-set bonus, 600 to 800. So this should give it a little bit more competitiveness, kind of returning its numbers to what it was at the start of last PTR. Demon Hunter just got crazy damage buffs across the board. Just absolutely insane. Sentry damage went up 300 to 400 on the 4-piece for Marauder. 6-piece bonus, each active sentry is increased from the damage that you get from 600 to 800%, and even the Lord Greenstone's Fan that people are using for the Fan of Knives Legacy of Nightmares build got a damage bonus increase. Instead of 80 to 100%, it's now 160 to 200% per stack. Meticulous Bolts got replaced with a new Elemental Quiver. This has a name in game, but here they just list it as an Elemental Quiver. So now it gives you multiple buffs to all of your different elemental arrow runes. So Ball Lightning travels at 30% speed, Frost Arrow damage and chill duration increase by 200 to 250, Immolation Arrow damage over time increase 200 to 250, and Nether Tentacles damage and healing increase by 200 to 250. So this could bring the Crider Shot back. Maybe we'll see like Marauder's builds using Crider Shot and maybe a cubed Meticulous Bolts? Or Elemental Quiver, or maybe, I don't know, that could be really interesting though. Let's see, Nats, just got a little bit of a damage bump on the 6-set bonus, 400-500. Shadow's Mantle got its 2-set bonus, which was the when you have a melee weapon equipped, bumped way back up, 600% to 1200%. Unhallowed Essence got another crazy buff. So for every point of discipline that you have, instead of being damage increased by 20%, it's now 40%, so doubled. Johnny Assaulter, rapid fire damage bonus increased from 30 to 40% to 60 to 75% per stack. Channeling time required to gain a stack decreased from 1 second to 0.5 seconds, and you now gain the first stack immediately. So they're really pushing that channeled build forward there. Monk, Flow of Eternity, get some 7-side strike damage. Sun Wuko set, decoy damage is increased 500 to 1000. 6-piece bonus, 1500 to 3000. Raiment set, Dashing Strike now also increases your spear generators by 300% for 6 seconds. Shenlong's damage bonus after reaching max spirit is increased 100 to 150. And then Uliana's 7-sided strike deals double its damage with each hit for the 4-set bonus, and the 6-set bonus also increases your exploding palm damage by 250%. Witch Doctor got a new legendary belt. Fire Bats deal 150 to 200% increased damage to enemies affected by Locust Swarm or Piranhas. Helltooth, 6-piece set bonus, damage increase 900 to 1400. Raiment of the Jade Harvester, 2-set bonus, instant haunt damage dealt increased from 60 to 120 seconds worth. 6-piece set bonus, instant damage dealt when consuming dots increased from 150 to 300 seconds worth. So just doubled up on that one, on both of those bonuses. Spirit of Arakir, 6-set bonus, damage bonus increase 1200 to 1500. Zunamaz's 4-set bonus, damage reduction per fetish increase 2%, 3%. 6-set bonus, 800 to 1500. Okay. Wizard, Delser's Magnum Opus, redesigned on the 4-piece bonus, so you take 50% reduced damage while you have slow time active, and your allies gain half this benefit. So before you actually had to stand inside your slow times to get it, I believe, and now this just means whenever you have it up, you just get that damage reduction, which is nice. A new ring, a new Halo ring, Halo of Karini. You take 45 to 60% less damage for 2 seconds after your storm armor electrocutes an enemy that's more than 30 yards away. So some ranged potential getting in there for wizards. Firebird's Finery 6 set bonus. Damage bonus for each enemy burning is increased from 25 to 40%. Damage bonus when an elite is burning 600 to 2000. So that's a nice big buff there. Nofer's Boast, meteor damage bonus increase 100 to 200. Damage when hitting 3 or fewer enemies increase from 150 to 200% range to 275 to 350% range. Tal Rush's 6-piece bonus, damage increase from 500% to 750 per stack. Twisted Sword can only go to a max of 5 energy twisters benefiting your damage output, so that they put a cap on that, which is good. And then Veers, to go along with all those crazy Archon changes, 4-piece set, also got a change where the damage bonus increased from 1% to 1.5% per stack. And then some more existing legendaries that were class-specific got some powers added to them, and you have to get the new versions of these. They will not automatically update. So Crystal Fist, they put a power on there, so Dashing Strike reduces your damage taken by 40 to 50% for 6 seconds. And then Flush Rake has a legendary power where Dashing Strike increases the damage of Dashing Strike by 75 to 100% for 1 second, stacking up to 5 times. It's interesting. So I guess those you would potentially wear both of those in your Raiment set. Witch Doctor, Swampland Waiters got a legendary power added. Using Sacrifice deals 350 to 400% additional damage to targets affected by Locust Swarm or Grasp of the Dead. Some bug fixes fixed for Firebird's Finery. It caused the set bonus to be granted the elite bonus damage when a rare monster minion was ignited. Interesting. Okay. Adventure mode changes. So this is a really nice quality of life change. In the event that both Act 3 and Act 4 bounties are complete, the bonus act will now always be turned in first. This was one where people were getting their bounty bag screwed up because they would turn in the wrong act that wasn't the bonus, and then you would just be upset and sad and all that good stuff. So that got fixed. Plague of Burrows, one of the bounties that people really disliked because burrows were hard to kill, significantly reduced burrows health. Nephilim Rifts, Greater Rift changes. This is important stuff here, actually. So the amount of incoming damage in Greater Rift 70 and above has been reduced. The amount of experience granted in Greater Rift 70 and above has also been reduced, and the cost required to empower and the gold awarded by Greater Rift above rank 70 has been reduced, but that ratio of gold earned to empower cost remains the same. So it should be cheaper to empower them, but you won't be getting as much gold. You won't be getting as much experience, which might help the solo and group disparity maybe shrink a little bit more. That'll be interesting to see, and then you'll be able to survive a lot more with the incoming damage reduced. So we'll be pushing up into higher Greater Rifts again, looks like. Set dungeon changes, Immortal Kings. Objective 2 requires you to kill 150 enemies while Wrath of the Berserker is active. Legacy of Rakor, enemies hit by Furious Charge that didn't hit 15 enemies are no longer prevented from counting toward the objective. Future Cast, Smite of the Earth, elites now appear in fixed locations. Wrath of the Waste, enemies hit by Rend that didn't hit 10 enemies are no longer prevented from counting. So before it was like if you tag some enemies and you didn't get the right amount, you couldn't reuse those enemies, but now they're basically allowing you to do so in some of these set dungeons. For the Crusader Akan set dungeon, total number of monsters was increased, and then again that same thing where if you didn't hit enough enemies with Condemn, you can still use them the next time you Condemn. Demon Hunter Marauder, objective 1 requires you to kill 140 enemies with 3 or more sentries active, and the total number of monsters has also been increased. The rockworms appear in fixed locations, and they now take longer to come out of the ground. Okay, Shadow's Mantle, you no longer break the consecutive hit chain if you hit a target that has already been added to the chain. That's really good, because before the shield ones especially would really break your chain, because you would hit them, they would lose their shield, but then they'd still be alive, and if you hit them again, it would break your chain, so it's a good change. Unhallowed Essence, enemies hit by multi-shot, same thing. If you didn't get enough with your first multi-shot, you can still reuse the same enemies. Witch Doctor, Raiment of the Jade Harvester, Deceivers will no longer use their invisibility. I know a lot of witch doctors are happy about that because the invisible thing was pissing a lot of people off. Enemies hit by a soul harvest that didn't harvest 15 souls no longer prevented from counting towards the objective on future casts. Same thing. And then Wizard, Delseer's Magnum Opus. Enemies hit by slow time. Same deal. If you didn't get enough, you can use them again. Firebird's Finery. Objective 2 now requires you to ignite or kill 20 enemies. And then they did some bug fixing where you could potentially prevent players from being able to finish a set dungeon under certain conditions. Crafting got some fixes. They fixed an issue that prevented the quantity of items to be crafted from being properly updated. And then they fixed an issue that prevented the list of affixes available when an item was being enchanted from being updated dynamically. Monsters. Pet attacks will also break Primordial Scavenger's armor in the same way players do. Amount of gold dropped by Gilded Barons has been reduced. I guess that's in reaction to the Avarice conquest. And then this one everyone's very happy about. Merciless Witch. Removed her shields in both the Realm of Discord and Realm of Fright, and significantly increased her health in the Realm of Discord. So, we actually can kill her very quickly now. You won't be upset when you see Magda, that's awesome. And then lastly, some user interface changes. Holding shift while comparing an item will now also remove the benefit of Caldison's Despair from the comparison, so that's nice. And when viewing a player's profile in-game, it indicates whether or not you are looking at the current profile. Inventory button no longer flashes for level 70 characters when a new item is picked up. Highest damage numbers will also be displayed in orange when shortened combat numbers are disabled, so when you're using the traditional system. And then a shadow has been added to stack and charge counts on the hotbar and buff icons. They also fixed an issue that prevented profiles from being properly updated when inspecting a player in-game after they had enchanted an item or socketed a gem. And those are your patch PTR 2.4.1 notes. Hopefully you guys get in there and try it out. I know I will certainly be.